I would not want to get on an airplane if the designer or the builder had said, deliver me some aluminum, deliver me some plastic, you know, deliver me some glass, and I'm going to put together an airplane, and I'm just going to see how it works. Why should an author of fiction be any less diligent than that? I sometimes hear authors say, I write for myself, and I think, no, you don't write for yourself. You write for your audience. There's nothing to be ashamed of in saying that. We write for consumers. People spend a lot of time investing in our books, and I think it's very, very important to give them what they want. My stories have at least three or four plots running simultaneously. We have to have a schematic. We have to have a structure that allows books like these, very tightly constructed, multi-plotted stories, that has to be very tightly tied together. There's some authors who are absolutely brilliant and can look at a blank computer screen and start from there. I can't do that, and I suspect that most authors who write the type of book I do, that is a commercial, popular novel, have to do some form of outlining. I may be a little excessive about it, but I'm also the sort of person that doesn't like to leave anything to chance. When I was a lawyer, I was doing mostly corporate law. What law helped me with is the organization about writing books. I outlined very, very extensively. I do about 8 months worth of outlining. It's a full-time job, 8-10 hours a day. My latest book, The Broken Window, the outline for that was about 190 pages, and it has every single element of the story included in bullet points. Then comes the fun part. I can sit down and write from start to finish. I have no problem doing that at all because I know where the story is going to go. Because at that point I'm working 10, 12 hours a day. I get a little antsy, as my grandmother would say. I have to get up and do things. So I come into the kitchen here, stand at the island, and write away. At the end of that 2 months, the book is done. And it's generally two things. First, it's too long because it's easier to write long than it is to write short. Second, it's usually pretty bad. Because it's very easy to write sloppily. It's much harder to write well and concisely. So what do I do then? Not to panic, I just go back and rewrite. Rewrite, rewrite, and rewrite. I'll do 30 or 40 drafts of a book before I send it off to my publisher. And I continue to revise it until the final day when they grab it from my hand and will not allow me to revise it anymore. Ernest Hemingway said, there are no great writers, there are only great rewriters. And I firmly believe that.